What up, y'all? The last 3 weeks has been crazy busy. So, starting with the Arnold Classic, which we flew to Ohio with Quest to represent Quest out there at their booth, which is hella dope, by the way. We almost died in a snowstorm. If you guys been watching the news, you guys saw what happened at LaGuardia with the New York airport. There was mad snow. We had crazy turbulence. And I was like, please, I don't want to crash like that plane. And then we worked all day over there. Booths are never easy. It's hard work. You're working from morning till night. You barely get any sleep. And then when you do lift, it's a shitty lift. I mean, I worked out with Max Tuning a little bit. And I worked out with a bunch of other people, Tim Thibodeau, Chelsea Lifts. And man, my lower back was just stiff from standing all day. And I was just tired. I fly back. I don't even get to rest in my house for 24 hours. I just throw all the dirty clothes out of my luggage, throw some new clothes in there, and I fly straight to Malaysia on another 22-hour flight. I get there, and then we have another show to do in Malaysia, and I'm hella tired at this point and jet lagged. And I was like, dude, there's no way I'm gonna be training. But then, good thing, before sound checks on the day of the show, I found 1 hour. So I found this little cute CrossFit gym in Malaysia. Shout outs to Pushmore, that's what it's called, Pushmore. And we went in, got a good workout, did the show, just got back this week, literally like 2 days ago, and I am jet lagged, I'm tired, it's just all this fatigue accumulation from the previous workouts and all the traveling. Finally today, I got to have a legit full workout, and I'm trying something new. I'm just gonna hit heavy singles on a lot of stuff. I'm borrowing some of the programming points from the Bulgarian method. And my squat, I did all right. I hit 415. I'm gonna just call it there because I know I still got a bench and I still got a deadlift. And then on bench, I think because my chest is still a little bit tight and sore from all the traveling, my 335 was hella slow. 315 felt pretty good, especially with my new form. My head doesn't really come off, my ass doesn't come off. I feel really confident that every lift is gonna be three white lights. But yeah, my bench started to cramp up a little bit, so I cut it at 335. Then on deadlift, I don't know what the fuck happened. It's probably because I haven't deadlifted in like 2 weeks. My form is jacked up. So like starting with 405, it just felt really slow, and it ended up looking like a wide stance conventional. I no longer was pulling sumo. I was doing wide stance conventional. Everything, all the weight was on my back, and I was like, you know, when you pull sumo, you release a lot of pressure off your back, and I'm like, what the fuck is that shit? I ain't doing this shit right, man. And then so the whole workout, I was like, man, it should feel slow. It didn't feel that good, and I was like, fuck. I finally hit some PRs on my deadlift. I'm getting some gains. I was like, man, I'm gonna pull 600 soon, but it started dropping again. And then it wasn't until block pulls where all of a sudden everything clicked again. And I found out the reason why. It was because on the other lifts, my toes were pointed way too forward. I think I got it confused with the way I set up my feet for squats. When I do squats, my feet are almost parallel. And I don't know why the fuck I set up like that for deadlift. And then also it was way more narrow. And when I did block pulls, I opened up my feet and had my stance a little bit wider, and boom, like my 545 speed was smoking it, and it was way faster than my 465 speed. So I guess the lesson of the day is sometimes you just lose your groove, sometimes you lose your form, but you just gotta keep finishing it because you never know when the light at the end of the tunnel is gonna appear. Oh yeah, and also a lot of you guys tell me that you guys love the short film documentary style workout videos. I love them too. The problem is that it costs a lot of money to shoot those because I gotta hire people to shoot, to edit, to light it, to fix the sound, and all of that. But now you guys can contribute to the making of those videos because I'm teaming up with this company called sparesense.com, and you can go in the description below. I'll put the link right at the top, sparesense.com. You can contribute 25 cents, 50 cents, a dollar, however much you want to the making of these videos, which is fucking awesome because now I can make more of the content that you guys like and you guys can help contribute to that. So make sure you check that out. Every time it hits the amount that I need, I will try to pump out as many of those videos as I can. So that's it. Make sure you check it out. Peace. You gotta build a strong foundation. You know, you can't be building big ass motherfucking buildings on quicksand is actually gonna be fucking swinging around and shit, and the building is gonna fall. Look at the Leaning Tower of Pizza. You know, that motherfucking pizza is about to fall over, and all the pepperoni's gonna fall off all the motherfucking